All right, it's our pleasure to welcome in Joel H. Cohen, who has written a book with broadcasting icon Dan Patrick. It is The Occasional Accurate Annals of Football. And this is the book right here. Take the glare off. It looks pretty good. And let's get into it, Joel. First of all, I got to ask you, what's your involvement with Dan Patrick? Have you guys had a relationship for a long time?
We certainly didn't before. And then once the book comes out, I'm sure we won't after either. He's already blocked my number and all sorts of security has assembled around his house. I work on The Simpsons is my day job, although I'm on strike currently. My day job is a writer for The Simpsons. And I actually reached out to Dan to be a voice on the show. And he is going to be in an upcoming episode that'll be on around November, December. But once he and I met, we started talking, and both, no surprise, of course, that he loves football, but maybe a surprise to him that I do. And we both had a lot of fun, I guess, funny slash interesting ideas, and thought maybe this is a book. And from there, we just sort of rolled it and built this book that you held in your hand a moment ago.
Well, I got to ask you, like, what's the dynamic then with you two working together? Because I read a lot of the book. I'm not going to say I read the whole thing, because I'd just be
lying. No one has read the whole thing. No one has read the whole thing.
There's a lot of great stuff in here, and I'm a huge football fan, so it was very interesting to me. But what is the dynamic when you're working with someone like this? Does Dan throw some stuff at you and you clean it up?
100%, and I throw stuff at him and he cleans it up. Very collaborative. What I loved about the opportunity to work with Dan is, forgive me, but sometimes the world of sports is not always the funniest segment of the entertainment industry, present company excepted. But so he just had some really funny ideas. One of the things in the book that I love and was one of Dan's many ideas was comparing Tom Brady's diet to Kenny Stabler's diet, you know, and just like the vast difference between the two of them. And he had really funny ideas about the Jets and about penalties and things you should never bring to a tailgate. And I had things that I threw at him, and we just kind of went back and forth and collaborated into the literary masterpiece it is.
Well, you joke about that and you say it like that, but I appreciate it because it's like a big book. There's a lot of stuff in it, but it's like a book on NFL snacks. There's no in-depth, you know, boring, long, traditional stories. I just love that you can go through it and you can basically snack on the football for every page. Was that by design?
What I'm hearing is it's a book made to be read on the toilet. That's what I'm hearing from you. But you know what? There's so much out there about the NFL. I love the NFL. I love pro football. I love all sports, but I love the NFL. And there's so much out there that is so dry and so boring and so analytical. So we try to have some genuine insights that genuinely tell the history of the league and the rivals and teams and players, but really have fun with it, because that is an angle I feel has been underrepresented, where people have really dug into the funny stuff that's happened in the NFL.
Well, that's the thing, is like you kind of go from decades, you know, 20s, 30s, 40s, you move on through the book like that. You isolate teams throughout the book. I wish there was a little bit more on the Lions. You know, I am from Michigan, and I saw this chapter that was the Habs and the Detroit Lions, and I go to the chapter, and there's nothing about the Detroit Lions in there. So you guys are just kind of messing with people, aren't you?
Well, listen, the Lions have been messing with you as a fan for how many years? But we do talk about the great Lions, Barry Sanders, as an example, and talk about some of the low, this may shock you, but there's been some low moments in Lions history, and talk about how, you know, they had both the longest punt ever against them and the shortest punt ever against them. And just like some embarrassing moments. If you're a fan of the Jets, you'll be particularly offended because, first of all, they're the Jets, but maybe they'll be better this year. But anyhow, we actually propose a solution to the Jets in the book. How to fix the Jets is one of our chapters.
I saw that one too. You also point out some cool things like the history of the Packers and where that all came from, because, you know, we know that this is the only team in the NFL that's owned by, you know, millions of people. And I think it's cool that you've introduced some history as well. So you try to satisfy a little bit about everything about the sport for a wide range of football fans. You're not just pointed to make some fun. It's informative.
Yeah, one of the things about a book that is lighthearted is it can really just kind of run away from you if it's just jokes. So we really wanted to pin it on content. And I learned a ton writing this book with Dan, but I think people that read it will, I hope, be amused, but also, dare I say, get educated a little bit about how the league started, you know, some of the low moments, all the rivals, how the AFL folded into it, et cetera. There's the history of the league is kind of the timeline or the spine of the book that the rest of it is built on top of.
No, I think it's great. I mean, it is educational for someone that's just a lot. Sadly, with my age being 59, I know that everything you guys mentioned was pretty familiar to me, which is, it's the younger people that read this book are going to go, wow, this is really interesting. And for me, I'm like, yep. But it's cool. Like, it's a great book. And it was a lot of fun. Was it fun for you to write?
I love it. I mean, as I mentioned, my day job, except for now, is I work on The Simpsons, which is incredibly rewarding, but also very collaborative. And when I say collaborative, I mean a pain in the butt, because I'm forced to work with, you know, 9 or 10 people to kind of get a episode on TV. And the great thing about a book was I was really just me and Dan and a little bit of the editors. But what I found most rewarding is just we were able to control the path as we wanted. And to some extent, the content, of course, as much as we wanted. And I find that very kind of freeing and rewarding. So it was great.
Yeah. Well, I like that also. There's so many things I like about the book. I'm not just lying to you and blowing smoke. I mean, there's just some really cool things about the book. And the beauty of it is it doesn't take a guy like me long to read it, which is great. So you've got this one chapter where you go through bits and pieces of the Super Bowls. And you pull out Super Bowl 49, which Seahawks fans are not going to want to read or even be any close, anywhere near it. But those were neat things too. Were most of those just all of Dan doing some research and you guys collaborating on that as well?
Yeah, I mean, we couldn't talk about every Super Bowl. We talk about many halftime shows as well. We couldn't talk about them all, but there are some that jump to mind. So we just tried to pick out some of the most iconic moments of Super Bowls, the catch. The drive, et cetera. You know, of course, the Seahawks, they won one too. Don't forget about that. I'm a Seahawks fan myself. But then there was one they didn't win. Spoiler alert. So we pick out some of the highlights of and lowlights of various Super Bowls and sort of that interesting moments explained, and even like the secret behind David Tyree's helmet catch. You know, it wasn't just athleticism. There was a magnetized cow and a magnetized helmet as well involved.
See, that's the thing, man. I'm reading this book and I'm like, is that really true? Did this really happen? Did he really say that? I mean, so did you guys take some liberties in this book? Like, did you, this is a lot of this stuff? Like, I'll let you answer that before I get to my next one.
Yes. I mean, it's the number one goal is for people to enjoy it and have fun and hopefully smile and maybe even laugh. But yeah, there's a lot of it is made up. For example, there's a section on the best and worst trash talk. And the first two or three are actual pieces of trash talk that have been said on the field. And then, of course, we go past that and we elaborate some things that may or may not have been said and talk about what actual conversations go on in fumble pileups. And those are all made up. And I hope, you know, discerning fans will be able to tell the difference between truth and fiction.
Well, the one trash talk you're talking about is J.J. Watt. One of them was J.J. Watt looking at a running back and saying he's eating bigger burritos than him. And
yes.
And that seemed like it was accurate.
That was 100% said. Absolutely.
That's
true trash talk.
Okay, let me run this one by you then. After Super Bowl II, Green Bay's they carried Lombardi off, and they forgot they had to have a trophy ceremony, so they had to carry him back onto the field. And then Willie Davis of the Green Bay Packers says, "We couldn't carry him again. He's heavy, and that hat weighs more than you think." Now, is that really a Willie Davis quote?
No, it is not. I made that up.
And that was really funny.
Well, good. If Willie Davis wants to fight me, bring it. I'm not afraid of you. He's probably older now as well. But yeah, now the truth, of course, we all know there's an iconic picture of them carrying Lombardi off the field. And then we go a little bit past that. Also, the book ends with a chapter about reporting on the season of 2073, which, of course, is also made up, or maybe it'll prove to be prophetic. But right now it's just made up.
It's just crazy. Like, you know, you have all this fame from writing for The Simpsons and you're so creative and your brother as well, Robert. And just, you know, I told people I was going to be talking to you today. They're like, whoa, you know, I was like, you know, Sylvie's got at least a B guest, not so much a C guest, you know.
No,
so
well,
I know you wouldn't clarify yourself as an A guest. I don't think you would.
Nobody would. No. Hepatitis A, maybe. But that's about it.
Yeah. So I mean, the mind that you guys, how much stuff had to hit the floor, but the edit room floor, basically, because it seems like you guys probably like, we should do this. And some of it just couldn't make it in the book, right?
Oh, yeah, tons. I mean, the book was really long, and just for ease of reading and also just kind of keep it tight and funny, so much stuff was written that just fell out. We just want to give enough to everybody that they do feel satisfied, that there's something on their favorite team, hopefully their favorite player, moments they remember, moments they learn about. But there's a lot of stuff, of course, we couldn't cover. The league's been around, 100 years? It's hard to get everything in there.
Yeah, I mean, I figured that there should be another book that, you know, some kind of edit room floor book that you could put out. You probably could fill out another book with the stuff you cut out of this.
Oh yeah. Are you proposing right now live on air that you and I write a book together? Because I'm in.
I have zero talent in that area. It wouldn't be Paul Silvey with Joel H. Cohn. It would be Joel H. Cohn and Paul Silvey looked at it. That's pretty much all it was said.
That's an oral contract.
All right, well, I appreciate that. I'll let you. I just want to ask you one more question. Like, as writing, you wrote this book and all these great chapters and all this great information. Was there one that stood out to you? You mentioned a lot of different things, but is there one that stood out to you that you enjoyed the most?
I really am quite attached to this one about the Jets, just because they're such a fun team to make fun of, and they've had so many embarrassing moments. Even just the butt fumble, you know, which is surprisingly called the second most embarrassing moment in NFL history. I'll leave the first for someone to read the book. But just the butt fumble, we wrote a song about the ballad of the butt fumble. There's a haiku about the butt fumble. There's a limerick about the butt fumble. There's so much. The Jets are such a rich area to make fun of. And so that was just wonderful to pick on them, and I enjoyed that chapter a lot.
All right, so you are, and you're doing a book tour, correct? Like, are you going to different cities throughout the country?
Well, Dan is going to be in, where the book comes out on September 5th, and on that night, Dan is going to be in a bookstore in Connecticut, and then the next weekend, one in Ohio, where he's from. But I'm actually going to be in Seattle on September 5th at the University Bookstore, and I would encourage anyone watching this, they just have to sign up. It's free. But they should sign up and come on down, and I would be happy to talk about The Simpsons, about the book, talk about how I feel this interview with you went, and just really, you know, meet anybody that wants. If they want a signed book, I'll sign your name, I'll sign Dan's name, I'll sign, you know, Warren Buffett, whatever they want. But yeah, so I'm in Seattle September 5th, and I'm on a bunch of podcasts, and lucky enough to meet people like you on TV as well.
You throw that out there kind of casually, but where can people listen to you on a regular basis?
Trust me, no one wants that. But I generally, I'm sort of just this guy in a room surrounded by ice cream and potato chips and a bunch of other losers on The Simpsons. But occasionally when I have a project like this flare up, I circle into podcasts and I'm on Instagram if people want to follow me at Sports Wrong. But really just I'm the guy that's meant to be in a room with the door closed. No one wants to see me. Here I am.
I'll tell you, man, you say that and you're humble and all that, but a lot of what you have and a lot of what you've written has been very funny. I'm sure people would enjoy listening and reading some of your stuff throughout the days to come. So, because I know all about you from your Simpsons days. So again, the book is The Occasionally Accurate Annals of Football, and it is written with Joel H. Cohn and Dan Patrick. So listen, we really appreciate your time, Joel, and best of luck on the book. I love it. I think it's great. So thanks a lot.
Thank you, and I hope to see people in Seattle September 5th if they're around, and thank you for your time. I really appreciate this.